Today, the national capital has witnessed one of the largest mobilization of students from across the nation to march to parliament with the demand of save education, the slogan of save education, save democracy and save the nation.
The last election, 2014 election time, maximum the youth supported Narendra Modi. Because of this, they assured that every year they produce 2 crore jobs. And this type of their assurance was there. That's why the students, the youth, basically supported Narendra Modi. So the change, it will happen from students and youth only. We are assuring that things. So this march will be today and tomorrow march will be the final nail on the coffin of BJP and Narendra Modi government.
हम लोग बोल रहे हैं बहुत हो गया गौशाला आप चाहिए हम लोगों को पाठशाला हम लोग चाहते हैं कि सबको शिक्षा सबको काम ये हो जाए क्योंकि हमारा देश में आप देख रहे हैं जो सरकार प्रॉमिस किया था 2 करोड़ रोजगार देने के लिए 2 करोड़ तो दूर की बात है कि 2018 में 1 करोड़ 10 लाख लोगों का काम चला गया है तो ये सब के खिलाफ हम लोगों का ये लड़ाई है
And what you are asking, what you are questioning is not only about education primarily, that there should be right to education, but you are also asking inside the education educational institution, how caste discrimination operates, how it's institutionalized, that within an education, the people who are coming from marginalized community, let it say Dalit or a woman or minority or people who are coming from linguistic minority background, how much institutionally they feel alienated and many of them chose to take a step what Comrade Rohit has taken. So from there, the resistance has started. And then we have seen the 9th February incident and the Occupy UGC movement where students actually became the voice of the nation, where we started asking the critical questions. We started asking that what is the idea of nationalism? The nationalism which is like so accepted, so normalized, we started questioning that. That when you talk about nationalism, it's not only about a map of India, but it's about the people who are living there. And the moment you don't talk about the livelihood question of them, the moment you don't talk about the well-being of those people, you're really not talking about nationalism.
Pulwama, that issue, that is their agenda. Every time they need some strangers, some enemies. So every time they are using some enemies, that is some Muslims. If they are from Kashmir, then it is very much good. And that's why every election time this is happening. And so many people there, they are joining in our military and they are not against our country. Even if somebody is against our country, that also because of this government's policy. So we are against that government policy from 1947 if these issues are happening in Kashmir. So that is not the problem of that Kashmir people, that is the problem of our government.
So we have redefined the idea of nationalism and that's where they are scared of. Because right now you can see that when this attack happened, CRPF attack happened, extremely saddened incident where 40 of our people had been killed. And if you look at their profiles, all of them come from marginalized background. They come from poor families. So it's the people of our families who are getting killed in borders. And this government, without doing anything substantial, is just trying to play that same nationalism card. And just before 2019 election, trying to create a binary. So today, where you're coming here, we are also trying to actually challenge those binary. We are saying that okay we want to go for war or not, that's a different case, but first let us ensure the people who are living in this country have that basic access to education, have the basic access to amenities, that we can have a dignified life.
They are victimizing students of particular areas. We are standing with all the students. We want to tell them that students are students, whether they belong to Kashmir or whether they belong to Kanyakumari. When you say India, then we need to stand for India, and our demands are we want banega and we will fight till that day we don't get it.
We have seen a systematic attack on education for the over the last 4.5 years. Under Narendra Modi government in different shapes and different designs. All aspects of all specters of education, be it school education, higher education, or the question of employment, the question of appointment of enough teachers, the question of distribution of scholarships, and the question of the academic institutions like GSK and academic councils, the security, the secular character of curriculum. Everything has been attacked and everything has been destroyed.
We are demanding fully state-funded education. Basically, in different states, so many education institutions, primary education institutions already shut down. More than 30,000 schools were shut down in Madhya Pradesh. Every state have this type of list to shut down schools.
90% of the Indian schools are running without proper facilities, without enough teachers, without toilets, or without any proper facilities in the campuses. This has been the situation in India. Three kind of attacks: the attack of commercialization, the attack of communalization, the attack of centralization. We have witnessed all these three kind of attacks in this education.
Jitna privatization mein bachcha kharch kar raha hai, usse kam kharche mein wo sarkari schoolon mein bachcho ko padhne ke liye वहाँ पर जितनी फैसिलिटीज़ है वो हमें वहाँ पर प्रोवाइड करवाए. हर एक बच्चे पे उतना पैसा नहीं होता है कि वो प्राइवेट स्कूल्स में पढ़े, प्राइवेट संस्थानों में पढ़े और वहाँ जाकर वो उतना खर्चा करे. अगर कोई हमें बोले कि हम वहाँ खर्च करके पढ़ेंगे तो हमारे बस का बिल्कुल नहीं है, हम इतना अफोर्ड नहीं कर सकते हैं. लेकिन हमारे अंदर इतनी स्ट्रेंथ है कि हम आगे बढ़ना चाहते हैं, हम कुछ करना चाहते हैं. उसके लिए हमारी सिर्फ यही मांग रहेगी कि हमारी सरकार हमें एक सरकारी संस्थानों में पढ़ने में हमारी वही फैसिलिटीज हम लोगों को दे जैसे कि हमारे प्राइवेट संस्थानों में मिलती है.
हम लोग देखते हैं कि हरियाणा के अंदर लगातार जो प्राइवेट दुकानें लगातार खुल रहे हैं, जिनके फीस जिनके अंदर फीसें लाखों के अंदर है, वहां पर एक जो गरीब किसान है, जो मजदूरों को कैसे अपने बच्चों को पढ़ाएगा. एजुकेशन के ऊपर जो खर्चा होना चाहिए लगातार पिछले सालों आप देख रहे हो लगातार घट रहा है. एजुकेशन के ऊपर GDP का 6% खर्च होना चाहिए और सेंट्रल बजट का 10% खर्च होना चाहिए. इन डिमांडों को लेकर जो सेंट्रलाइजेशन है एजुकेशन का वो नहीं होना चाहिए. नॉन नेट फेलोशिप जो सेंट्रल यूनिवर्सिटीज के अंदर मिलती है लेकिन स्टेट यूनिवर्सिटीज के अंदर अभी तक नहीं मिलती है, तो स्टेट यूनिवर्सिटीज के ऊपर अंदर भी वो नॉन नेट फेलोशिप मिलना चाहिए. इन तमाम मुद्दों को लेकर हम लोग हरियाणा से विद्यार्थी आए हैं.
हमारी जो सरकारें हैं वो आज एजुकेशन तो दे ही नहीं पा रही हैं, लेकिन एजुकेशनल इंस्टीट्यूशंस में गर्ल्स की सिक्योरिटी को भी इंश्योर नहीं कर पा रही हैं. आज हम देख रहे हैं कुछ ही दिनों पहले की BHU की घटना है और बहुत सारे स्कूलों की भी घटना है जहां छोटी छोटी बच्चियों के साथ रेप हो जाता है और उनके जो बलात्कारी होते हैं वो खुले घूमते रहते हैं. और जब हम डिमांड करते हैं कि हमारे इंस्टीट्यूशंस में सेक्सुअल हरासमेंट के अगेंस्ट कमिटीज़ होनी चाहिए, जेंडर सेंसिटाइजेशन कमेटी अगेंस्ट सेक्सुअल हरासमेंट, जिसको JNU के अंदर कुछ टाइम पहले एबॉलिश करके एक नॉमिनेटेड बॉडी को वहाँ पर लाया गया, इस तरीके से हम लगातार देख रहे हैं कि स्टूडेंट्स की, गर्ल्स की सिक्योरिटी को लेकर आज हमारी सरकारें कुछ भी करने में नाकाम है. एजुकेशन बजट को लगातार कर्टेल किया जा रहा है. लगातार हम देख रहे हैं DU के अंदर भी फी हाइक हो रहा है, कॉलेजेस की फीस लगातार बढ़ती जा रही है. इन्हीं सब इश्यूज़ को लेकर आज हम यहाँ पर इकट्ठा हुए हैं.
ये डिमांड जो हमने लगाया है साधारण छात्रों के लिए, साधारण स्टूडेंट को जो पढ़ नहीं सकता है, जिसका गणतांत्रिक अधिकार कैंपस से छीन लिया जा रहा है. आप लोगों ने देखा है JNU है, हमारा कलकत्ते पे JU है, इस सब विश्वविद्यालय के अंदर जो RSS का प्रभाव बढ़ रहा है, छात्रों के ऊपर जो अत्याचार हो रहा है उसके ऊपर हमने ये नारा लगाया है. इस नारे को लेके आज हम पार्लियामेंट मार्च के लिए यहाँ पे आए हैं.
एंड आवर डिमांड्स आर वेरी सिंपल. Demands which we shouldn't ask for in 21st century, like it should be a fundamental right of all the people for free education and employment. This BJP government came into power 5 years ago with the slogan of 2 crore jobs, and we are demanding it. If within 5 years there should be 10 crore jobs, but if the jobs are there, why the youth is on the roads of Delhi?
They failed to produce 2 crore job, and so much people's job also lost because of GST and not one and other their big policies. And 24 lakh central government jobs are now vacant. They are not ready to fill that also.
So that's why we are demanding. We want BNEGA, Bhagat Singh National Employment Guarantee Act. We want a parliamentary stamp on BNEGA so that nobody may deny Indian youth for employment. There should be a parliamentary guarantee. It should not be a privilege. That's why we are asking that education and health and employment should be the basic rights of the students.
शिक्षा विरोधी सरकार को ये पता चले कि आखिर हमारी जरूरतें क्या हैं. आखिर हमें क्या मिलना चाहिए, हमें शिक्षक क्यों नहीं मिलते, हमें सही बिल्डिंग क्यों नहीं मिलती, हमें अच्छी टाइम पे एजुकेशन क्यों नहीं मिलती, हमें साइंटिफिकल एजुकेशन क्यों नहीं मिलती, हमें वो घिसी पिटी एजुकेशन क्यों दी जाती है, और हमें हर तरीके से सुविधा एजुकेशन के लिए क्यों नहीं दी जाती। अगर आप शिक्षा नहीं दोगे तो महाराज अच्छा देश कैसे बनेगा, शिक्षा से ही तो अच्छे देश का निर्माण होगा, अगर शिक्षा नहीं मिलेगी तो देश कहाँ से बनेगा।
Now when we mobilize students from across the nation, the ruling class using their lumpen elements in campus called ABVP attacked our students in different campuses, especially in National Capital and Delhi University. We have been attacked physically and injured very badly by the ABVP elements in Delhi University. But this is a message. This is a message that with the physical assault and injury, you cannot stop the rising student community in this campus. We, the students in this campus, will rise up in defense of democracy, secularism and the social justice in this campus.
देखिए मोदी सरकार देश की जनता के खिलाफ, स्टूडेंट के खिलाफ एक जंग ऐलान किया है। उस जंग के में वहाँ पर हम लोग देख रहे हैं, हमारा फंड कट हो रहा है, सीट कट हो रहा है। एक तरफ जियो यूनिवर्सिटी के लिए करोड़ों रुपया दे रहा है सरकार, यहाँ पर जो यूनिवर्सिटी तैयारी नहीं हुआ वहाँ पर ट्राइबल हॉस्टल बंद होने जा रहा है।
दिस शोज दैट दिस पीपल हु क्लेम टू बी द नेशनलिस्ट इज एक्चुअली नथिंग बट दे आर जस्ट द स्टूजेस ऑफ द कॉर्पोरेट्स। दे जस्ट बिलीव इन अ आइडिया व्हिच इज मनुवादी, व्हिच इज ब्राह्मणवादी। दे बिलीव दैट एजुकेशन शुड बी only you know should be accessible to only handful of people, the people who are coming from privileged classes, privileged caste. And we here, when the thousands of us are marching together, we are not only marching against the government and their policies, but also all these mechanisms which they are using to curtail it down, all this organization which claimed them to be the students organization and actually work against the interest of the students. Today we are here against this wholesome attack on education. We are here today against this wholesome attack against the youth of this country.